Hello everyone, welcome back again to Military TV. Today I'm going to take you to see why the T-14 Armata is superior to other main battle tanks, MBTs. Before watching this video, don't forget to leave your comment below if you have any suggestions or certain topics to discuss for the next videos. The Armata T-14 was first demonstrated during the Victory Day Parade in May 2015 in Moscow. The actual production of the tanks was delayed. The first 9 T-14 Armatas were originally planned to be handed over to the Russian Ground Forces, RGF, in 2018. This date then got pushed to 2019 and then to 2021. The T-14 Armata can be accurately described as the first true Russian tank to land a contract for production, as it is the first tank design to do so that came after the fall of the Soviet Union. Design work for it began in 2010 at Uralvagonzavod, which also designed the T-55, T-62, T-72, and T-90 tanks. Russian tanks used to rely on high-tech foreign components and some subsystems. Now the entire information management suite, hardware and software, is all domestically produced. The tank measures 10.8 meters long, 3.5 meters wide, and 3.3 meters high, and has a combat weight of 48 tons. The T-14 Armata is based on a modular combat platform, which can also serve as a basis for other armored variants, such as a heavy infantry fighter vehicle, IFV, and armored personnel carrier, APC. The hull is divided into three compartments: a crew cab at forward, an unmanned remote-controlled turret in the center, and a power pack at the rear. The driver sits on the left, gunner in the middle, and commander on the right inside a special armored capsule. Entry and exit are provided through three hatches in front of the hull. The roof of the turret houses a meteorological mast, satellite communications, global navigation satellite system, data link, and radio communications antennae. Talking about the T-14's engine, the tank is powered by an A85-3 turbocharged diesel engine capable of 1,500 horsepower coupled to a 12-speed automatic transmission. A85-3 is a turbo-piston diesel engine sometimes named 2A12. A85-3A engine is used on an Armata universal platform. The development of the engine was engaged in the Chelyabinsk Trans-Diesel Design Bureau. It was produced on the Chelyabinsk tractor plant. There is information that the Armata would also have electric transmission to reduce the weight of the vehicle and increase the use of add-on armor. The suspension consists on each side of 7 dual rubber-tired road wheels. The T-14 Armata can run at a maximum road speed of 80 to 90 kilometers per hour with a maximum cruising range of 500 kilometers. All Russian tanks have only 6 road wheels, but the suspension of the T-14 Armata on each side consists of 7 road wheels with the idler at the front, drive sprocket at the rear. The high-powered diesel engine and transmission constitutes a single unit that ensures high maneuverability. The active suspension improves the tank's sway resistance on rugged terrain, thus enhancing the target lock time and fire accuracy. Now, let's take a look at T-14 Armata's design. The tank is designed around the unmanned turret, which makes it unlike any other main battle tank MBT in service and gives it a unique set of advantages and disadvantages. The T-14 Armata is armed with a 2A82-1M smoothbore gun. Since it employs an automatic loader, the T-14 needs no gunner, 57mm grenade launcher, and a 12.7mm machine gun. The 2A82-1M 125mm smoothbore gun is supposed to provide 15-20% better accuracy over the gun currently fielded in the T-90 main battle tank. The remote control machine gun is installed in its own robotized turret and integrated with the tank's fire control system. In general, the T-14's weapon systems is an automated one, with all of its components except for command and control ones located inside the unmanned turret separately from the crew. The T-14's armor protection is even more controversial. The crew is protected by an armored fighting capsule with all around 900mm protection against armor-piercing fin-stabilized discarding SABO, APF-SDS, 1400 against high-explosive anti-tank warhead, HEAT, which is not impressive in itself. However, the armor is complemented by 4th-generation Malakit Explosive Reaction Armor, ERA, which supposedly boosts the effective armor by 50%, making 1350mm against a PFSDS. Then there is the massive Afghanit Hardkill Active Protection System, APS, which the Russians got to defend successfully against weapons traveling at 1,700 meters per second and are trying to get up to 3,000 meters per second. Also, quite suspiciously, sources claim it can protect against APFSDS rods. Basically, excellent protection. With the introduction of the explosive reactive armor, which is basically an explosive plate that propels the armor plate to resist penetration of the projectile warhead so it doesn't damage the steel plate and prevents further penetration, the armor can even withstand anti-tank missiles and gunfire, with ammunition 120mm uranium M829 looks like America's. The Russian Defense Ministry says the Armata's main combat features are a high level of passive and active protection, superior to that of any other armored vehicles. The tank's original silhouette, combined with the special coating, considerably reduces the vehicle's visibility in the thermal and radar range of observation. The wheels are partially covered by anti-heat rubber skirts. The tank's sides above the wheels have built-in reactive armor screens. Anti-heat grills, screens, cover the engine's exhaust pipes in the rear. Extra fuel tanks are behind the armor, which considerably bolster the tank's durability. The armor is capable of withstanding the impact of any current anti-tank weapon. The engineers who designed the vehicle say its resistibility is 15% greater than that of any other armored vehicle having the same mass. The tank's frontal protection is approximately equivalent to that of a 1200mm to 1400mm steel armor plate. The passive armor protection of the hull and turret is combined and consists of composite materials and the newest armor steel. Another protection is Active Protection System, APS, Afghanit. This system automatically detects enemy anti-tank shells and guided missiles and returns fire with special munitions to destroy them. The system functions in automatic mode only. The APS is capable of intercepting any approaching weapons, guided anti-tank missiles, rocket-propelled anti-tank grenades, and shells fired with man-portable anti-tank grenade launchers, armor-piercing sabots, air-to-surface missiles. The active protection system provides defense from ordinary munitions and weapons that attack from above. This says it all. The United States anti-tank missile TOW is detected by the tank's active protection system, which automatically emits an aerosol smoke screen, thus rendering the missile uncontrollable. After getting a bit of information on the T-14's armor protection, we absolutely want to know where the tank is tested. In the Middle East, Russia's T-14 Armata tank has undergone testing in Syria, a senior Russian official said. The testing was the latest example of Russia's military checking the capabilities of its advanced weapon systems in Syria, a war zone where foreign powers have deployed forces. According to officials, the test will allow specialists to see the new tank in action under real combat and desert conditions. Deputy Russian Ground Forces Commander for Armaments, Lieutenant General Viktor Levinsky, told journalists in late August 2018, "You know, we will test the tank in various climatic conditions, and not just in the central Russian upland. We will certainly try out the tank in the north and the Arctic, but we will probably have to deploy it in the mountains and sandy deserts. We know that the United States had some negative experience operating its Abrams M1 tanks during Operation Desert Storm when virtually all their engines malfunctioned. Therefore, we need to try out everything, including specific computer parts and the influence of Aurora Polaris on it." For the last part, we're going to see the prospective customers of the T-14 Armata. Moscow has already received export inquiries for this tank. However, it will be possible to ship the tank abroad only after the beginning of serial suppliers to the troops. The T-14 Armata has been of great interest to both the Russian army and foreign customers. And last month, Russia state's arms seller Rosoboron Export announced that the T-14, along with the T-15 infantry vehicle, could be demonstrated to potential foreign buyers at the Army 2020 International Arms Show. Industry and Trade Minister of Russia, Denis Manturov, had earlier announced that they are already receiving requests for the deadly T-14 Armata tanks from several foreign customers. Experts believe that apart from India, there are few countries that can handle the Armata's sophistication. I would point to the UAE and Egypt as two potential customers who have experience in using sophisticated American, European, and Russian hardware. Algeria may be a potential destination too, given that it already has sophisticated Russian military hardware, such as the recently delivered Terminator anti-tank vehicle. Finally, India is a key destination for Russian military high-tech, such as the T-90 tank. India's high dependency on Russian munitions can be seen, as 86% of the equipment, weapons, and platforms currently in military service in India are of Russian origin. Countries like Belarus, Egypt, India, and Vietnam are also regular customers of the Russian munitions. So, the T-14 is high-tech and possibly with superior capabilities to competitors. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next videos.